The path of self-reflection. We are very pleased to give you the best of who and what we are with each and every energetic message, and know that as we do, we set an example to all of you of how to be in the world, in the universe you are creating. You do want to put your best foot forward, and your best foot forward is really your vibration. It is the energy that you broadcast out into the universe, and has nothing to do with you being perfect as a physical human being. It does not matter how disorderly, untidy, or muddled you may look when you hold space for a loved one to be who they really are. You are there to become the best version of yourself as a being of unconditional love, and not as a human producing and creating art, books, or a healing center. While all those are wonderful, you need to listen to your intuition when being called to create anything for your fellow humans to enjoy with you. Understand that the offering of yourself to this universe is enough of an offering. Many of you are attempting to work out what it is that you need to offer that is tangible and recognizable by others as a contribution to humanity. All that is required is for you to just radiate love and know that you are having the impact that you want to have, while simultaneously opening yourselves up to more inspiration. You do not need to work out what the end product will be, as that something that represents the love you are radiating will also come through you and be produced by you. Do not overthink or overanalyze in your head, where you are very limited in your capacity to come up with exactly what you will offer to your fellow humans. Therefore, let go of the need to work out what your offering will be. Instead, continue to open up in your heart space, because that is where you access your multi-density self and is where your higher consciousness exists. Being the highest version of yourself means coming from your heart, and it is with your mind that you remind yourself of that. And it is from your heart that you want to channel all your energy through. You can use your mind to focus on anything, your heart, a tree, a flower, or a cloud, anything that will put you in that higher vibrational state so that you can receive the inspiration. Once you have started to create your offering to humanity, you must remain disciplined and stay in that heart space and not use your mind to criticize what you are doing, second guess or analyze it, or try to break it down and determine its value. Be yourselves, come from your hearts, and meet us in that reality where we are doing the same, and we can co-create with you. However, we are not the only ones who will do that. We are not the only ones to co-create with. There are so many beings who want to collaborate with you, who want to love you and hug you and tell you how wonderful you are. They are all capable of doing that because they have decided to be the highest version of themselves, to come from their hearts and to love, because love is who and what they are. Use your powerful minds to focus upon that, and once you let go of trying to work out what you should be doing, you will feel immediate relief and feel yourself being heart-centered in the very next moment. Understand that it is still all right, okay, if you do not do anything. However, since you are becoming more of who you really are in every moment of every day, you might as well start right now to do that consciously and deliberately. You are beginning to realize more and more that you do not have to do it all yourselves, and you are beginning to sense the importance of this lifetime for you and of this time for humanity. You are meant to come together as a team of light workers and to be a collaborative effort. You are also beginning to recognize that not only do you have helpers in many forms and densities, nor do you have to solve all the problems of your own lives by yourselves, while trying to work out how to receive that assistance. We want you to understand that once you unburden yourselves, taking the weight off your shoulders, you can and do receive the assistance that is there, and in the many ways that it can come to you. If you are fixed on the assistance to come only one way, then you cannot see that the help is coming from a different direction than the one you have been expecting it to come from. You may be looking only down one corridor for the assistance to come to you, and because you are so narrowly focused, you cannot see that there is help coming from another passageway, in a different direction than the one you have been looking in. This also applies to receiving your spiritual gifts and abilities. You may think that you must have one particular gift, and that it must come through one way, a course, a book, or a person. However, there are numerous ways for you to receive and access your spiritual gifts and abilities that you desire. All that is required is for you to unburden yourself of the weight of the world and consciously and deliberately affirm to yourself that you do not have to do everything. Remember that there are many other light workers out there who do want to connect and coordinate with you. They want to collaborate in all the ways that you do. However, unless you reach out to them or open up to the possibility of one or more of them opening up and reaching out to you, you will never know that. Once you recognize that this is all your creation, you can rest assured that you are creating it all. However, you are not meant to do it all through this one body or even one lifetime. You do not have to make everything happen or reinvent the wheel. You can receive and access a spiritual gift from a version of your soul, from a so-called past life. You are there to experience much more than you have been experiencing. However, you are also there to change the way you approach things and deal with them, accomplishing things and receiving what it is that you want. Look to find the various or different ways of approaching it. Ask yourselves how you can receive more than you have been receiving. Start going down that path of self-reflection that will absolutely help you to identify the ways you are limiting yourselves and using a very narrow-minded way, or coming from a rigid perspective approach to your life circumstances and the things you want to change within it. Relax and remember that you have soul family members in physical form that you have not yet met in this lifetime. Know also that the number of helpers you have around you is far greater than you think it is, and realize that so much is already in motion that you do not ever have to start from scratch to get anything. You are there as the continuation of the expansion of your soul, which is a very large timeless being. Remember that you will always be taking the next step on your journey, and even when you have no idea what the next step is, it is always there. And as you are willing to move forward and have more faith and more trust, you can receive more assistance to change the way you are living your lives and to change the world for better. And this assistance comes from all above and all around you. And those are the two things that are everyone's purpose, no matter who they are or what they are living. We require nothing of you, and yet you ask the world of yourselves. You ask yourselves to be everything that everyone else needs you to be, and to do the impossible and be perfect so that you may ascend into a higher density. We see yourselves as being perfect already. Therefore, we suggest that you take it easy on yourselves and see yourselves as simply being on a journey. It is a journey where at times you will swerve off the path and at times try to avoid debris on the road and still drive over it. It is a journey where a bird or a small animal may run across the road in front of you and you hit it. We are sharing that no matter how hard you try, you are not going to have a perfect journey, and you will not always do what is expected of you by others. Hurting someone's feelings from time to time is unavoidable. These things happen, and they are meant to happen, because you are not there to have a perfect journey by your standards or anyone else's. You are there to grow from the imperfections. You are there to come closer to one another because of your arguments, disagreements, and struggles to get along. You are there to once and for all give up the idea that you are supposed to be something other than what you are. And when you can accept yourselves as you are, you can accept everyone else as they are. You can allow everyone else to be who they are, allowing them to be not perfect as well. Understand that you all make your own mistakes. Therefore, there is no need to condemn, judge, or imprison everyone who has committed an offense. After all, you all get to have your bad days. And once you see them as opportunities to release something or forgive something, you will start to understand that. When you see everything as perfect as it is, even though it might look like a mess, then you are starting to see the world and each other as we see you. Those of us in the higher realms want you to know that your journeys are perfect as they are, and that you were meant to slip up at times, so that you could forgive yourselves. You are meant to not have all the answers, so that you can ask for help and receive it. It is important for you all to be exactly who you are, because you are a puzzle piece that is completing the puzzle of this universe, and you are completing the puzzle that is source energy. We are here to assist you in discovering what is within yourselves to help you forgive, love, heal, and have compassion, and not to tell you what to do or to follow rules. And we want you to know that only once you have held a level of mastery that you would choose to incarnate there on Earth, because you knew how challenging it would be and knew that others would challenge you there and push your buttons. You knew that people would disagree with other people on very important topics, and you knew that it would then become your task to see the source energy within them, to love them anyway. That is your task at this time, no matter who you are or who you have been. You will be arriving in that place where you can see the perfection in all and in everyone, and you can live your lives accordingly and allow everyone else to live theirs as well. We also know that life there on Earth can be quite challenging at times, and you need to remind yourselves to not allow low-frequency thoughts, ideas, or reactions to what you are going through in any given moment to affect you, because we have seen what happens when you do. By allowing your life circumstances to pull you down vibrationally, you then cannot get the answers that you require. You cannot see, think, or feel your way out of where you find yourselves, because your focus on the reality of your situation as being what it is. When you get bogged down in the muck and the mire, you forget that you have created the problem for yourself in order to grow from it. You forget in those moments that every problem must have a solution in this universe of duality. You need reminders at times such as these, that there is always a way out, and the way out is usually to go up. In other words, if you remove your attention off your problems long enough to go and do something playful and fun, that is when you will naturally raise your vibration, so that the solution, the answer, can find its way to you and you can find your way to it. We are not saying you should pretend something is not real when really it is, nor that you should stick your head in the sand, because you are there to face that challenge that is in front of you. However, what makes this lifetime different from all others is that you are there to face it in a different way than you have ever faced it before. You have different tools and better strategies in this lifetime. You cannot fight your way out of a lower vibrational state. What you can use are incorporated teachings that are new to you in this lifetime. However, at times you can allow yourself to reach your rock bottom, if you need to, in order to fully surrender and fully let go. While some people take that route, and they give you the opportunity to lift your vibration, then do so. However, if by doing or watching something that makes you laugh, or by going to the oceans, walking in the forest, or if calling your loving, compassionate friend assists you to lift your vibration, then do so. You do not have to go through what you are going through on your own, nor do you have to struggle your way out of a hole that you find yourself in. It is important for you to recognize that things are always changing, and changing for the better. Therefore, your circumstances will change if you allow them to, simply by taking your attention off them. Otherwise, you may find a temporary fix solution, where you will find yourself not too far down the road with the same circumstances, or very similar circumstances. We want you to recognize that it is always a good idea to raise your vibration, even if you are just doing it to give yourself a sense of relief, even if you do not expect to get the solution to your problem by doing something. Do it anyway, and do it for the momentary relief that you will get from it. Allow yourself a break from the problems you have created in your life, because for those moments that you are not focusing on it, you will simply enjoy feeling better. By changing yourself, you will change the circumstances, and this can be applied to every single problem, scenario that is in your life, or that will ever be. This we know because we have observed enough of you, and because of our own physical experiences that we have had in our past histories that we can draw upon. There is an inner peace that we feel is present there on Earth, because we know that everything is ultimately going to be all right for all humans, even though we know it could be better. We also realize that when you're in the middle of an experience of despair, ill health, poverty, and so on, that you do not know that everything is going to be okay. To fully feel the emotions available to you there on Earth, you must have doubt, which is why you do not know that everything is going to be okay. It must all seem very real, and in order for those emotions to be experienced, you all have to believe that there is a chance that things are not going to work out. Once you experience the emotions enough times, you come to recognize that despite all the unpleasant and unwanted things that you have had to do and face in your life, you survived. And despite all the negative emotions you have had to feel, you moved through them. Most people on Earth tell their story of going through their dark night of the soul with a sense of nostalgia because they realized how strong they were in facing those challenges. Most people also recognize how the dark night of the soul served them. Therefore, you always want to be aware that you have created everything that you are experiencing in your lives. Secondly, you always want to be aware of the truth that whatever it is that is in your life, no matter how horrible, it is there because it serves you somehow. And thirdly, you always want to be aware that you can discover how it serves you and benefits you. These steps allow you to come to a place of acceptance. And when you are in acceptance, you let go of resistance. When you let go of resistance, you allow in all the assistance that is available to you in every moment of your lives. You can tell when you have resistance to something because you feel it. Sometimes you feel it in an emotional way, and sometimes in a very physical way, while at other times it is a mental anguish that drains you to the point of exhaustion. And know that when you are not feeling great, physically, mentally, or emotionally, that you have some resistance to something that is required by you to find a way of accepting. Once you realize that everything is your creation and has not been thrust upon you by an outside force, it becomes easier to accept. When you realize that something serves you and you will benefit from everything that is in your life if you can find the way that it serves you, it becomes easier to come to that place of acceptance. As a soul, you will always survive, heal, and somehow find relief in some way. When you seek to find that inner peace, that relief, that trust that everything is going to be all right, you will reach that place faster, taking with you the benefit of all that you have experienced. We know that it is a challenging time to be there on Earth, and we do not mean to diminish your suffering in any way. Our intention is always to give you a way out. You are deciding what would be better without resisting what is now the way it is. It is a tricky and difficult assignment for most people to understand, However, it is your mission to become your higher self, the self that sees all, knows all, accepts and loves all. And you are getting there gradually, experience by experience and moment of surrender by moment of surrender. And once you love it all and see everyone as source, you will know you have finished with this experience and this earth. Te wāna, tāua, te awa.